A young couple in love until tragedy struck. Joshua Davies committed suicide 2 years ago. Now his de facto partner, Ayla Cresswell, is the face of a landmark court decision in Australia. Whether she can use his sperm and IVF treatment to have his baby. A Brisbane justice today deciding she can.
My client's very relieved, but thank you, she doesn't want to make any comment. Thank you.
25-year-old Ms. Cresswell's fight began soon after she discovered her partner's body in 2016. The sperm had to be removed within 24 hours, with permission granted in an early morning emergency court session. But the more protracted battle has been about whether she can now use that sperm. The court hearing she's got the blessing of both her and Mr. Davies' family. His friends have provided affidavits saying he wanted children.
This is a precedent-setting case here in Australia and it'll be watched with interest in New Zealand. Fertility Associates has told One News while we do have instances of sperm being removed from recently deceased men, there are no known cases where it's then been used to impregnate a woman in New Zealand.
That's unless the woman has prior consent.
In New Zealand, we've had a situation where a guy has died unexpectedly and we've been asked to store his sperm, which we have done so, but whether or not his partner will ever be able to use that sperm remains to be determined by the courts. So we're really interested in what happens across the ditch.
The justice also deciding Ms. Cresswell is capable of raising a child on her own. And while she didn't want to speak today, this tribute she posted in 2016 gives a sense of just how emotional this legal fight has been. Kimberly Downs, One News, Sydney.